To a sign, we take the kids to the bush and show them animals, tricks and birds.
It's important for the kids to learn to wear signs so the kids can be Hindi and so they grow up.
When I was school kid, I always go with the elders and learn.
Emily is Anangu teacher.
At Pipalyatjara, they've definitely developed a strong two-way science program. Community decide what's important for their children to be learning about. That learning happens both on country and in the classroom. Then we share that. So it's full circle because it's saying, this is what's important to learn about. This is the learning that's been undertaken. This is us showing community that we have followed through and done that.
It empowers AEs and community members who are the experts, the ones that lead that learning out on country. Two-way science is a teaching and learning cycle, so it involves planning together using the bush planner and the integrated planner, learning out on country, and then following up with that learning back in the classroom, then assessing that learning, and then finally sharing the learning. We've been learning all about the different types of birds, using our clipboards with photos of the birds to collect that data, then taking that data back into the classroom where we've linked it to maths, creating data tables, creating those graphs, and then speaking with the students about why do you think we saw so many of those birds in that location. We've also linked this with visual arts, and you'll see in the classroom there's a giant tree display with many of the birds that we've seen out on country, with the names of the birds in both languages. The AEs, they are the experts. So when we go out on country, I'm with them, but I'm learning from them and they're the ones teaching the students. Then we go back into the classroom and we use more of the Western science in the curriculum, but we work together to still teach the students. When we're all working together, you can see the students engaging and they're learning in both languages.
The teacher learns from us.
She always with the kids. And she learned too. Kids and teacher, they're learning together.
We are actually now at a point of having students achieve at year level in science. Another key area that we are excited about is around wellbeing, and we think our two-way science program, with the emphasis on identity and on culture, that we feel like that's building students up from within.
When I come to the country, I feel good.
We have had really increased engagement from community members. A real highlight of the community celebration that we had in the form of an open classroom last year was having grandmothers, grandfathers, mothers, aunties, uncles coming into the classroom and seeing photos of the learning on country, seeing Anangu educators teaching their young Anangu students. It really has been a point of celebration within our community. We worked really extensively with our Anangu staff to set up some guidelines for what learning on country is, which is really explicitly going out on country with a purpose and collecting that key evidence and what learning are we going after while we're on country and what can we bring back to the classroom as well.
I teach them and they teach the kids too. And when they grow up, they can teach.
I learned from my grandmother and my mum. My mum, she was a teacher, Pipalyatjara. I learned from her when I was school in Annabella.
Anangu can lead the two-way science, our country. Because Anangu know the country and the dreaming and Jokotpa.
Keep the language strong.
Strong.
No one.
They speak language at home and school, or when they go out, they speak Pipalyatjara. They come inside the classroom, they learn Pipalyatjara.